I do want to welcome you to the 7th annual Fulton County Women's Giving Circle. We formed this group in the fall of 2010, but we immediately started to meet in either May or June to award our grant monies. I am currently the chair of this group of caring philanthropic women who want to do good things for their community and its residents. For anyone that doesn't already know my name, I'm Judy Climie. Besides welcoming you this evening, it is my job to make introductions and to try to keep things moving along on schedule. So, do we have, I know we do, but would any new guests this evening raise their hands, please? I know we've got, yes, we've got, all right, so thank you. We thank you for your interest in our group, and I sincerely thank the person that invited you to attend. I hope that they have explained that our group goal is simple. We draw upon the wisdom and resources of Fulton County women to create a better community through charitable giving. We have no monthly meetings, no fundraisers. We simply pool our annual dues of $120. We award half of those monies each year to grants, and the other half is invested in an endowment fund through the Community Foundation. This fund will grow forever and benefit Fulton County indefinitely. I do hope that this is something that interests you and that you enjoy being with us this evening. Look around you at the women in this room and feel their power in making a difference. To honor Nancy Reagan, who we lost this year, one of her famous lines regarding women is this: "A woman is like a tea bag. You cannot tell how strong she is until you put her in hot water." Strong women, welcome. And as always, I wish to put out the official mat to everyone. I'm so glad you're here. It's just a delight to see you, especially on a night that's not quite as nice as some nights that we've had. So I appreciate it. Along with my welcome each year, I have always given you a financial update on our endowment fund. I am pleased to let you know that in 6 years, remember we did not start collecting funds until our second year, our current balance is $39,721.33, just under $40,000 in 6 years. That's in that endowment fund. In grants, we have awarded $29,000 in those years, and we'll award an additional $5,000 tonight, making a total of $34,000 that we've given out. So the endowment fund, almost $40,000, and we've given $34,000 to our community. Ladies, our fund is growing. At the beginning, did we think we could make any difference at all in our community? We ask, should we try to start such a group? Were we a large enough group to make a difference? I guess we finally agreed with such wise men as the Dalai Lama, who simply said, "If you think you are too small to make a difference, try sleeping with a mosquito." I am here to tell you that we have made and continue to make a difference. We went that extra mile to start something new in our county, and it has been full speed ever since. I think we proved what Roger Staubach said: there are no traffic jams along the extra mile. Think about that for the people that you know that go above. There are not many of them, are there? Before going any farther, let us bow our heads and ask for God's blessings on this evening. Our Heavenly Father, please bestow your blessings on this program and all of its planners and participants. I thank you for their time and efforts to help make this a successful and enjoyable endeavor. Bless those in attendance as well as our absent members. Bless each and every person for their charitable hearts. May we continue to share our many blessings with others. We humbly ask for your blessings and guidance this evening, as we make decisions that will further impact our community. Amen. Now let me make some of those introductions and say thank you to some very important people. First of all, a Community Foundation staff. We welcome Jay Albright, our Northern Indiana Community Foundation, the Executive Director. Corinne Becknell-Lucas, who has the title of New Associate Director, who among her many duties handles our grant programs. Allison Heidi, where's Allison? There's Allison. She handles all of the scholarship programs for all three counties under the NICF. Brian Johnson, back there, he's Fulton County's Director of Development, but not more importantly, he's my faithful setup and tech person. I wouldn't even know how which cord to plug in for these things. So, also, I want to introduce our current intern, Jessica Monnet. Jessica's back there. Jessica hails from Peru, and I've been told that she won a scholarship from Miami County, and she was so appreciative she wanted to give back to her community foundation. And she is now helping and making great contributions in all three counties. Northern Indiana Community Foundation is over Fulton County, Stark County, and Cass County, Miami County, excuse me. So those are the connections that the Northern Indiana Community Foundation has. I want to give a big thank you to all of these people for the help with food, decorations, and setup. I understand Corinne found the little teapots and the candles. They purchased some flowers. And Jessica Michael, our secretary and office manager there, that you see her face when you come in, she did all the arranging, putting those flowers. I think they're just adorable. So thanks, everyone that helped out. I appreciate it. Next, let us recognize the members of our Grants Committee, who accomplished the difficult job of sifting through this year's 9 grant requests and narrowing them down to 3 organizations who will be making their presentations to us this evening. Those committee members are Shada Baylor. I think she said if she got here, she was going to be late. She's got a couple other meetings. Carol Bitzler. There she is. I knew I saw her. Priscilla Burge. I saw her. There she is. Linda Leisure, I saw her. Rosie Metzger, I saw Rosie. And Jennifer Smith, I thank you to all of you. Great job on that, so thanks. I will introduce our entertainers a little later in the program, but again, welcome to all of you. Thank you. I will now ask Jenny Smith from the Grants Committee to come up, make a few comments about this year's granting process, and then it will be on to hearing from our 3 2016 finalists and all about their projects and programs. So thank you, Jenny.
Thank you, Judy. I know I speak for all of us when I thank you for all of the effort that you have put in establishing this organization and spearheading it. We appreciate you. My name is Jenny Smith, and I have been on the Grants Committee for the last few years. The Grants Committee is a group of, this year there were 6 of us that get together and review those applications. We do that with the Northern Indiana Community Foundation staff, so that is very helpful. If that's something that you would like to volunteer for when you are writing out your dues, there is an insert that you can make that known for your preference to help out. We appreciate that, and we do need to rotate through who sits on that committee. What happens is there is a call out for organizations to submit an application, and we try to make our application something that gives us important information but isn't a burden on the organizations that are applying. Then we receive those applications, and the fabulous staff gets it ready for us, sends them out to us. We review, and we need to narrow down how many then that we'll present this evening. If you were here last year, or even just look on the back of your program, you can see that there were 5 groups that we chose to award to last year with a varying amounts. This year, we have $5,000 available to grant. And so that is part of the process, is to decide how we should split those monies. These 3 applications really rose to the top out of the 9. And so we felt like it was wise to invite those three and split the proceeds as follows: $2,500 for the top vote getter, $1,500 for the second place, and $1,000 for the third place. So every organization here, going home a winner. Nobody's going home with less than $1,000. So we like to do that to honor their time that they're putting in to come and present to us as well. So tonight when you vote, you will choose your top vote getter, and then we will tabulate those and distribute the funds accordingly. But first, we want to hear more about these organizations. You have on your voting card, that yellow card, I didn't bring it, I don't know, that's probably not yellow. Cream, whatever that color is, yes, very nice. On that ballot, it gives more information about each organization. And so after they're done, if you want to look a little bit more through there, you'll have some information to review. But we are going to start tonight with Junior Achievement. And Julie from Junior Achievement is going to come up and tell more about their Economics for Success program. Thank you.
Thank you. Junior Achievement's mission is to inspire and prepare young people to succeed globally in today's economy. It's the world's largest organization dedicated to giving young people the knowledge and the skills that they need to succeed in owning their success and plan for their future and make smart academic and economic decisions. Today, Junior Achievement is composed of 30 counties that compose Junior Achievement of Northern Indiana. Fulton County is just one of those counties. You can't hear me and you need to talk a little bit louder, Jay? Got it. Thanks. Annually, Junior Achievement of Northern Indiana ranks third in the nation in market penetration as far as the number of students that they reach. 34% of the students in the service areas, including 74% of the students in grades kindergarten through 12th grade in Indiana's second largest county, Allen County, and sixth in the total number of the students served, trailing only to Chicago, Houston, Georgia, and Upper Midwest and St. Louis. I think that is huge coming from Indiana. Okay, I know that seems small to you. I take great pride in that, working out of the Northern Indiana office and here locally in Fulton County for you and for the students here in Rochester and in Caston school systems. Here in Fulton County, there is a local board of directors. Eileen Howard serves on that, and also Katrina Pontius here in the coral colored sweater is also here, and she's been mingling with some of you ladies this evening, serve as well. The Board of Directors was established in 1987 here in Fulton County, and we have approximated it to be around 40,000 students that we have reached through our JA program since that time period. Our programs focus on financial literacy, work readiness, and entrepreneurship. JA Economics for Success is a seventh grade program that explores personal finance, students' education, and career options based on their skills, their interests, and their values. It also demonstrates the economic benefits of staying in school. How do you think that JA impacts Fulton County? Let me tell you. Junior Achievement programs are delivered by caring, trained adults from within the local business community and by other community volunteers. JA impacts Fulton County youth and the community as a whole in a number of ways. Employers continue to report that finding good workforce with employees who have the soft skills necessary to succeed is difficult. JA receives this need as well during the school day to prepare the young people for the workplace and the workforce and economic success in the 21st century. Students' interactions with positive adult role models from the community enhance their learning and their understanding, in addition to sharing each program's lesson guides, discussion points, and the activity materials. These adults use discussion opportunities to showcase local economic opportunities and realities with the students. They personalize the discussions and they stress the necessity for the students to develop their needs and their personal level of education, skills, and their aptitudes, while also putting their own personal flair onto this material that we're giving them. JA responds to the educators' requests annually to keep the programs into their classrooms and provide the critical lessons and skills needed for their students to make these sound financial decisions now and for their futures. During the 2015-2016 academic year, approximately 1,500 students will be served through the JA programs, as well as taking the vital lessons and information learned home to their families. That doesn't include the many adults that will benefit by engaging the youth as mentors or the classroom educators who have hosted these programs. The community as a whole will benefit with these young people who are more capable of succeeding in the workforce and by making these sound financial choices. Thank you for your continued support and your consideration.
Thank you, Julie. We appreciate you coming and sharing with us. Next, we have Mary Kay, and she's going to come and speak with us about the Fulton County Youth Leadership Academy.
Well, first, I just want to thank you, because when Judy said, "Do you guys realize what a difference you make?" I am here to tell you that as a SIOT and also as Executive Director of Compassionate Health Center, the dollars that you have awarded in previous grants definitely are making a difference. So thank you for all that you do. But tonight, I'm here to sell you on leadership. I'm asking you to invest in the future leaders of Fulton County. And why is that important? We hope to take students from the three county schools and teach them about leadership. They're already good leaders. We just hope to add to their leadership skills. We meet with them through the school year, and so what the Leadership Academy is a group of 20 juniors. And the reason we select juniors is that we hope that through the year and learning about leadership, they go on to be really strong leaders in their senior year. We also introduce them to many of the Fulton County businesses. And we often hear, especially over in this area, we go to Pike Lumber, and some of the Tippy Valley kids tell us, "We never knew Pike did all of that." We go to R&R Visual, and who thought that a young student who followed his dad cleaning septic tanks would end up forming a company that would go all over the world? And so when these kids hear these type of things from our community leaders, it really does make a difference for them. We select juniors from applications that we get, and then we spend the school year with them, meeting about 11 times. And tonight, what we're asking for is you to support two of our biggest initiatives that we do during our Leadership Academy. The first is our day at Geneva Center. That's in September, and sometimes it's the first that these students from three different county schools come together. And it's a real team building day, and they enjoy that camaraderie and networking that they build on that first day. And then the last session is our other request, and that's our etiquette session. Gloria Carvey, and I'm here to tell you, she has it nailed when it comes to etiquette. She just spent the day Friday with them, right before prom, which was so apropos, and she shared with them not only business etiquette, but social etiquette as well, and then we had a four-course formal dinner. And so those are the two projects that we are really asking for the extra help on. And your dollars all are going to help to cultivate and grow the future leaders of Fulton County. We talked to them at their second session about brain drain, and they kind of look at us like, "What does that mean?" "Well, I'm going off to college, and I'm going off to some big city, and I'm never coming back." And we introduce them to people like Joe McCarter, who did come back. We introduced them to Amy Rowe, who actually cried when she talked to them, and she was so upset that she was crying, and she said, "I'm just here to tell you," in that sweet little southern drawl she's got now. She said, "It is a great place to come back to." And so we don't think we know all there is to know about leadership, but bringing all of these important leaders and businesses together really do share a lot of amazing leadership skills with these juniors. And by the end of their year, we really hope they know more about their county, and they know more about leadership, and they know more about why they're going to come back here and be future leaders here in Fulton County. So I hope you'll consider investing in the future of Fulton County, because we need strong leaders to come back and be good leaders in our community. So thanks for your consideration.
Thank you, Mary. And next we have George Mowdy, and she is here to talk with us about the Fulton County Council on Aging, specifically their activity programming that they're looking to have more funds for.
Thank you. My name is Georgia Mowdy, and I'm the director at the Fulton County Council on Aging. And if you don't know where we're located, we are right across the street from the library in Rochester on Pontiac Street. Some other offices that the community center houses there, the RSVP, the food pantry, United Ministries, housing comes there now. And we also have a heating assistant program that comes for a few months during the year. So that's a little bit about who's there. The purpose of the Fulton County Council on Aging is to provide services and programs that enable and encourage senior citizens, low-income individuals, and disadvantaged persons to maintain independent lifestyles as long as possible. We strive to add life enrichment programs and activities that will appeal to the senior population and benefit their lives physically, emotionally, and socially. We are a nonprofit organization, and we receive grant money, and our activity department basically runs on local donations and that grant money. I applied for this grant to help our activity department with various needs throughout the whole year. We have a roundtable breakfast the first Wednesday of every month where we have a speaker come in on anything from nail and foot care to how to fill out your will, just all kinds of different subjects they come in and talk about. And then we serve a small breakfast, and the seniors really do enjoy it. So we have a newsletter also that some of you may get that goes out every month or to about 1,100 people right now. The newsletter contains a menu for the Area 5 meals that we serve in our dining room every day to the seniors. It has puzzles, just all kinds of fun little stories. And to mail that out every month, it costs around $200 just for the postage. So we also have the paper, the ink, and all that. But we really love it, and the seniors enjoy it a lot, and we really want to continue. So some of the money would go for that. And we have holiday dinners for the seniors at every holiday. We have a cookout in the summer. We have exercise several times a week. We play bingo three times a week. We have euchre, we have bridge, we have dominoes. So there's a lot going on there. We have special programs. We have the Manitows come in around Christmas and sing. We had the Notables last week, which we enjoy a lot. In fact, next Thursday on the 19th is our senior games at the community center. It's kind of like a small little senior Olympics. And we have a softball throw, we have bingo, we have darts, we have a beanbag toss, and they really like it. We have some real competitive seniors there, so we have a lot of fun. If any of you ever want to stop by, you're very welcome to see what we do offer, and I'd love to have you come in and talk to me and just visit our community center. It's really nice. And if any of you want to receive a newsletter if you're not getting one now, just call the center, give us your name and address, and we'll be sure to get you one out. So with the grant money that you're awarding this evening, I would just like to put this toward all these activities for the seniors so we can continue to make them happy. And thank you for choosing us as one of the finalists for your grants.
Thank you, Georgia. Okay, now this is the time you need to get out your cream ballot and be thinking, which one organization would you most like to see have the $2,500? Remember, all of the organizations will go home with money tonight, but by whatever one you check, you are saying, this is the one that I choose to have that highest amount. As you're thinking about it, we are going to hear from one of our recipients last year. In fact, they were one of those middle recipients, the Psi Iota Xi Books Program. And instead of having Mary come up and talk about that as well, Tammy said that she would come and do that. And so Tammy Hooker is here to talk about what the grant monies that you donated and voted for last year have gone on to do.
Well, thank you very much for helping us this last year. Your gift was very generous, and I have lots of books to show what we have done with that money. I am Tammy Hooker. I'm representing Psi Iota Xi. Our sorority works on and contributing to the community's speech and hearing, art, music, and literature. And of course, you know, we can eat and sell so many cheese balls and so many geraniums, we still have few extra dollars that we need to come up with. So the program that I talked about last year was called Books, which was Books Offer Our Kids Success. And the goal of our sorority is to provide a book a month to every kindergarten student in Fulton County. We spent between $1 and $3 each on each of the books that went to Columbia and Caston Elementary and Akron Elementary. That totaled 295 books per title. So when my neighborhood, I see a couple neighbors here, when all the Scholastic books arrive on my front doorstep, it's quite an interesting sight. I just pray that I'm home when they get there. Over on our table, I brought the study guides that the sorority sisters got together, and we created activities that the parents and the children can do before they read the book, during the reading, and then a little activity that they can do afterwards. And it just gives them a little extra incentive to keep the discussion going, because books is what we think it's all about. We have provided this year Biscuit in the Garden, Petting Zoo, which is one of the two nonfiction. We also have Caterpillars and Butterflies, because the going trend now is to have not only nonfiction but fiction, even in down in kindergarten. Two Crazy Pigs, Buzz Said the Bee, one of my favorites. And my little two-year-old granddaughter loves this one as well, and she always gives me all the sounds. Once there was a bee who sat on a duck. Quack, said the duck, there's a bee on me. And the duck said scat, but the bee just sat. So the duck quacked again and sat on a hen. Cluck, said the hen, there's a duck on me. And the hen said scat, but the duck just sat. Now, for those of us that are educators, this is like our heaven of short vowel sounds here. we've got Dixie and Magic School Bus Gets Recycled, and one of my favorites, the Pout Pout Fish. I do believe that all of them this month will be receiving on our way to first grade, because then it is time for them to pack up in 11 short days and head on to bigger pastures. So. The goal that we had was that the children of Fulton County will succeed by reading, by being read to, and by being doing the rereading over and over again. Obviously, we know we're in a poverty area. The free and reduced lunches percentages keep going higher and higher. We're above 60% overall countywide. Books in the home, it's not a priority. And unfortunately, it needs to be in order for us to have the successes like Mary was talking about here earlier. So I thank you for helping us get 9 books into every kindergarten home in our county this year. We hope that you'll continue to support us in years to come. And I have to share one of my favorite posts that I have a tendency to go towards in Facebook. Picture of this darling little baby with the, you know, studious eyeglasses on with a book opened up. And it says, it's called reading. It's how people install new software into their brains. We've got to have the little ones reading so that we have more success here in our county. So thank you. We'll hope to see you next year.
As Tammy said, you know, it sparked a reminder for me to say that the applicants for our grant, we ask winners to take a year off, but there is not a maximum that they could apply outside of that. So some of the organizations that we've given to in the past, if they so choose to apply again and our grants committee feels like they rise to the top again, they could come back and receive more grant funds from us, but just not one after the other after the other. So I hope that you had the chance then to go ahead and vote on that front page. There's big rectangles that it says please check one. So if you haven't, please take a few seconds to do that. Then we'll have our staff members come and collect those as we have our entertainment.
All right, I'm going to bring us back to order a minute. I do want to thank you for coming and talking about one of our recipients. I just feel good when we hear about what our money has done in the past year. And of course, as a retired teacher, I love that books went out. And I have to, at our last Friends of the Library meeting, a retired teacher who still goes back and works at the high school level says that kids, even those high school kids, you think they're reading everything on their iPads and whatever, they're to the point already, that's homework. They want a book in their hand. So I think, again, that's just a wonderful thing. So we made a difference with that group this year. So at this time, while our ballots are continue to be counted, we are in for another treat. It is my extreme pleasure to introduce our entertainers for the evening. We have two individuals that have agreed to grace us this evening with their talents. I first saw Rocky Adair perform back in the winter at one of Akron's Third Friday Jam sessions. I was immediately impressed. Of course, I love country music, but I loved his singing. And I approached him that first evening and asked if he would consider performing for us. He asked me a few questions about our group, said he would think about it, check his schedule, and get back to me. I thought, okay, may never hear. But I guess he decided we were a legit group and we were doing good things, because he did indeed get back to me, and right away, I might ask. And he said he would love to come. In one of the emails that we've exchanged, he asked if he could bring a friend with him. So we will be having a double pleasure this evening. These fellas are from Manchester area. I guess I shouldn't say the Manchester area. And Rocky tells me that he's going to tell you more about the two of them during their performance. But I honestly think the message in their music will speak volumes for them. Please help me give a really warm welcome to Rocky Adair and Derek Cordle.
It's all yours, folks.
Life is choo-choo come, and days come, and that's the time. It's thinking way my darling, never to bring her.
guys, come and play for you tonight. We appreciate it very much. My name is Rocky Adair, and this is my friend Derek Cordell. And although bluegrass music is our what we love to play, it's not all that we're limited to. So the next few songs, we're going to play some of the other songs that we know. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's go!
Thank you, Rocky and Derek. I really appreciate that. He brought the house down singing that last song, and I said, I don't care what you sing, but you got to include that. And if you aren't familiar with Chris Stapleton's version, he wrote that song. He does a great version, too. If you're not country, you might be an Adele fan. She has recorded one from that, too. But I think he rocked it tonight with that one, you guys did. So thank you. And you know, music is just so uplifting, isn't it? Even when things may not be going well, it can heal and lift our spirits. It reminds me of what Voltaire had to say about life and music. Life is a shipwreck, but we mustn't forget to sing in the lifeboats. So I think that's true. I think now we're going to have some announcements for our recipients tonight. So, Jenny?
I have had the privilege of knowing Judy for a few years, and I knew she was a woman of many talents, but I did not know she was a talent scout as well. But I'm so glad you are. That was fantastic. Thank you. I have three quick requests before I get to the fun announcements. The first request is, if you or someone watching on RTC knows of an organization that would benefit from our organization granting money, please encourage that organization to apply. Contact the Community Foundation on Main Street and they can set you up with the application process. It's very simple and we want to make sure we are impacting others in Fulton County. The second one goes along with that. You all have your cards on your table, and so if you have a chance to fill it out tonight, fantastic. If you don't, you have until December 31st, so many months to do that as well, to be a member for 2017 so that we can grant even more funds next year. And this goes right along with it. There is a brochure on your table. And this is a great thing to hand out to people that you think would be wonderful members of our organization. Like Judy said, it's no monthly meetings, and yet a big impact. $10 a month, which equals $120 a year. And if you're watching on RTC or you have someone that doesn't necessarily want to mess with a check, you can donate online. And there are instructions on how to do that in here. So you can go to the nicf.org website and click on Make a Donation. And in the comment box, note Fulton County Women's Giving Circle. Or, of course, stop at the Community Foundation for more. Yes, Carol.
Jenny, how many members do we have at this time?
71 this year.
71 this year. So if you noticed it was slightly, it's amazing how I knew that. Yeah. We did have $5,000 to grant this year, which is no small feat, but that is a little bit less than we have in previous years because it's dependent upon how many members joined that year, because of course half of it, like Judy says, goes into an endowment so that we can keep giving funds for a long, long time, and the other half is granted immediately. So, but tonight we get to give three organizations some money. Our first organization that we are going to announce is the $1,000 winner, and that is Junior Achievement. We'll have Julie come up so we can get a picture. We need to like make big checks or something. But we'll shake hands. We'll call that.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Our $1,500 grant award winner is the Fulton County Leadership Academy. So Mary, please. We really didn't call each other about how we were dressing tonight.
I like this jacket. She's a Caston grandma, too. I need this one.
Thanks. You. And, of course, that means our $2,500 winner is the Fulton County Council on Aging. And I think Judy has some final remarks.
Yes.
Oh, fantastic.
I do want to congratulate all of our 2016 recipients, and we are happy that every one of our finalists gets to go home with some money. No one leaves empty-handed, and we've covered that, but it never hurts to say that, because we're proud of that fact, that they get something, and in the past, a few times, they've even gotten more than their initial grant request, so they are really thrilled when they leave here. I want to leave you with these two thoughts. Tom Lehrer said, "Life is like a sewer. What you get out of it depends on what you put into it." May God help us to continue to put good things into our lives. The second thought is about staying motivated to continue doing those good things and helping others in our daily lives. Zig Ziglar, don't you love that name? Zig Ziglar said, "People often say that motivation doesn't last. Well, neither does bathing. That's why we recommend it daily." So let's keep that in mind. I want to thank RTC and Scott Sager. This is a first for us to have our evening televised or to take film. I'm not sure if and when it will ever appear, but they came and we thank them for that. So it's always good to try new things. Reminders of the cards, is there going to be a place to collect those? You'll take them. If you want to pay tonight, Jay will take them. Please do take home information flyers to friends and family. Jenny's talked a little bit about that, did a great job, but take them home for other people. Share. Talk about our group. So, thank you all. Good night, everyone. God bless, and may you have safe travels home.